In this video, I'm going to show you how to earn $1 billion. How's that sound? Pretty awesome, right? See, here's the deal. Most people say, hey, I want to make a lot of money. I want to make $1 million, $1 billion, whatever. But they're going about it all the wrong way. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to draw you a chart of what it actually takes to earn $1 billion. And we're going to use the example of J.K. Rowling, who's been the most successful author of modern times financially. So up here in this vertical line, we're going to look at money, and we're going to have our goal to be making $1 billion. And I want to talk about J.K. Rowling's story real quick. So, you know, if you know J.K. Rowling, she's the author of the Harry Potter series, most successful book in modern times, and she's now a multi-billionaire. And, you know, she started out over here with approximately $0. You know, she was broke. She was in an abusive relationship. She had some kids. She, you know, got separated from her partner. And, you know, she raised her kids as a single mom, broke, working side jobs, and started writing her books from there. And so here's what she was doing. She was working, right? So she was broke, but she had this dream. She had this vision. Over here, she's working. She's working on writing her books. So every day she's sitting down at her desk writing her books. And, you know, a lot of folks talk about when it comes to making money, making a whole bunch of money, you know, the law of attraction and visualization, you know, things like the movie The Secret. And they say, you know, if you just sit down, you think about and you visualize $1 billion, you will be rich one day. It'll come to you because you visualized $1 billion. And that's complete bullshit. Because here's what J.K. Rowling did. She didn't sit at home visualizing $1 billion. She didn't sit and watch the movie The Secret all day long and write in a notebook that she wanted to be real rich. You know what she did in her notebook? She wrote down the story for Harry Potter. You know what she visualized all day long? Harry Potter. You know what she worked on all day long? Harry Potter. You know what she did when she submitted her first manuscripts to publishers, and here she was broke down here, and she submitted and she got rejected the first time? What did she do? She submitted to another publisher. She got rejected again. Again. Got rejected, again, got rejected, got rejected, got rejected, got rejected, got rejected, got rejected, and kept working on it. Got rejected, got rejected, got rejected, kept working on it. 20 some times she got rejected her manuscript from different publishers, and she kept working on it. She's broke, working on this for years, year after year after year, still broke. What is she visualizing? $1 billion? Nope. She's visualizing Harry Potter. She's working on making the story even better. She's working on making her dreams come true. She's working on creating something that's unique, that's valuable to the world. And she didn't give up on her dreams. And she kept submitting, kept submitting, kept submitting, kept submitting. And finally, she gets a book deal. And she gets a little bit of advance. It's like, you know, $100,000 or something. It wasn't very much, right? And then she got this great advance. And she got a little bit of money. And she's definitely not a billionaire yet. But then sales start to take off. Yep. And then book 2 comes out and sales start to take off a little bit more. And then book 3 comes out and sales start to take off a little bit more. And then book 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and sales keep going up. And then the movies come out and it keeps going up. And then there's the merchandise and the video games and all the other stuff going on. And eventually she becomes a billionaire, right? And she wasn't visualizing being a billionaire. She wasn't thinking about becoming a billionaire. For year after year after year after year, what was she working on? Her books. Her mission, her project, her dream. She wanted to make her dream come true. She wanted to turn her story into reality. And that's what you have to do if you want to become a billionaire. If you want to become successful financially, stop thinking about the money. That's the result. What you want to think about is the work. The work is down here. This is what everyone wants to avoid. They don't want to look at the work. They don't want to have their dream come true. They don't want to sit down and write that manuscript again and again and again and go through the 5th draft and the 10th draft and the 50th draft and the 100th draft. They don't want to go through the rejection after 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 rejection and keep going, because all you want is the easy money. You want the fast money, but that's not how you get rich. You get rich by adding value. You make lots of money by adding massive value to other people's lives. That's how capitalism works. And so if you want to be able to do that, you got to do the work. You got to put the time and effort and energy in. And so stop visualizing the money. Stop visualizing the end results. What you should be visualizing is doing the work. Remember J.K. Rowling sitting at home visualizing her story, thinking about Harry Potter, thinking about dragons and Voldemort and muggles and all this stuff, right? She's thinking about this whole storyline. She's thinking about her world, her universe that she's creating. So whether you're starting a business or writing a book, whatever it is you're doing, and you want to make a lot of money doing it, focus on the work. Focus on making your dream come true. Focus on the activity every single day you got to do. And when you get rejected, don't visualize the money. Don't give up. Don't quit. visualize the work. How can you make your work even better? How can you edit your manuscript to make it even better? How can you make your business even better? How can you add more value to the world and to the marketplace? That's how you get rich. That's how you make $1 billion, by adding a massive amount of value to the world. And you don't give up when you get rejected. And you don't give up when things don't go your way. And you don't give up because you didn't make $1 billion in the first year or first 5 years or first 10 years, because you know it's going to take time. You know that you do it because it's worth it, because it's worth it to you, because you care about the work that you're doing. Successful people, they don't visualize money. They visualize their work, right? They're thinking about when a billionaire gets up in the morning, he's not thinking about how much money he's got. He's thinking about what he's going to do at work. How are we going to add more value to his company, to his business, to his life, to the world? That's what these folks think about. That's what J.K. Rowling's thinking about. She's a billionaire today, still writing books. You know, so here's a lady who was writing books all day, every day, for year after year after year, even though she got rejected. She got rejected. Did that stop her from writing? Nope. She kept writing. Did she get rejected again? Did that stop her? Nope. She kept writing. Did she get rejected again? Did that stop her? Nope. And now she's a billionaire. Did that stop her from writing? Nope. She's still writing. Because she wasn't focused on the money. She didn't care about the money. She cared about the vision, the work, the goals, the dreams, because that's what matters to successful people. The goals, the work, the vision, the dreams, that's what matters. And so if rejection can't stop you and billions of dollars can't stop you, guess what? You're unstoppable. So what stops most people from being successful? It's not the lack of money. It's not the lack of opportunities. It's not the rejection. Is that what really stops you is that you don't really care about the work. You're not really committed to your vision. You're not really committed to showing up every day and doing what it takes to become successful. That's the truth. That's the honest truth. If you're not where you want to be financially, it's because you're not doing the work, period. Action is what creates results. Action creates results. A lot of folks sitting at home, visualizing, sitting on the couch, visualizing the results. Successful people visualize the action. They're thinking about, what can I do today to make my life better? What can I do today to make my book better? What can I do today to make my business better? That's what successful people do. So you want to be successful, you want to get the results, focus on action and activity, because that's where it's at, my friends. So I hope this video has been helpful for you. I hope you do become a billionaire, a multimillionaire. I hope you make all of your dreams come true. But it's not going to happen if you just sit around, visualize, hoping things are going to get better. Hope is not a strategy, okay? Hope is not a strategy for success. If you want to be successful, you got to take action. Don't visualize the results. Visualize the activity. What are you going to do? What are you going to create that's going to add value to the world? What are you passionate about? What would you do if you got rejected 100 times and still do it just as passionately? What would you do if you had $1 billion and would still keep doing just as passionately? That's what you should be doing with your life, because that's what fucking matters. That's what you care about. If you're willing to do it when you're broke and get rejected hundreds of times, and you're willing to do it when you're a billionaire and the money doesn't matter to you, guess what? That's probably something you actually care about. So why don't you spend your time on earth, whether it's, you know, 50 years, 100 years, how much time you got left? So why don't you spend the time doing something you actually care about, something that actually matters? And if you do it in a way that adds value to other people's lives, that adds value to our society, you will be paid. You will get rewarded. That's how capitalism works. So yeah, I hope this has been helpful for you. I hope you take action. I hope you will put this into your life and actually do something that matters to you. Not because you might get these results someday, not because someone else said, your parents said you should do this, or society said you should do that, or you should have a fancy car. Again, you know, successful folks, they're not thinking about the cars and the money and the yachts and all that stuff. They're thinking about the work. They're thinking about doing something that they actually care about doing with their lives. So focus on that. What is it you care about? What is your dream? What is your vision? And go out there and make it happen. Hey there, it's Tom Corson-Knowles, best-selling author of Rules of the Rich. If you like this video, please go ahead, buy a copy of Rules of the Rich on Amazon.com. Please like this video, share it with your friends, everyone you know, share it on Facebook and Twitter, Instagram, post this all around, and leave a comment. Let me know what you think. What is your dream? What is your vision? And are you going to actually make it a reality? Are you actually committed to being successful? Are you committed to doing whatever it takes to turn your dream into a reality? Post your comments below. I'm looking forward to connecting with you guys. Have an incredible day. Take care.